We have already done with, we are already done with the solution of free vibration of underdamped system. So let me put the things in perspective once again. So what we have done is we have pulled this mass towards right by amount u0. And when the mass is at position u0, at that time we have started observing the motion of the mass. So we call that time as t equal to 0, and then we leave the mass. The mass oscillates about its mean position because the system is now underdamped system. That means C is less than C star. And then the solution is given by this equation. U of t is equal to e raised to minus C by 2mt into bracket u0 cos bt plus u0 dot plus cu dot by 2m upon square root of k by m minus C square upon 4m square into sine bt, where b is given by square root of k by m minus C square upon 4m square. I hope you remember till this point. Please respond in chat box if you are with me. Yes, Satyam says yes. So now let us go ahead. Now you will be with me in saying that whenever I see the terms like C, M in the solution, we get little uncomfortable. We want some dimensionless numbers to pop in the solution. For example, if you could remember, let us take a digress. I hope you have done a column, you have done a design of column subjected to biaxial bending in your RCC course. So you must have studied this diagram, which looks something like this. Have you studied these interaction curves? We call them interaction curves. And on x-axis, we have something called as mu by fck bd square. Fck bd square. And on y-axis, we have something called as pu by fck bd. Do you remember these curves? Please respond in the chat box. Such interaction curves you must have seen for design of RCC columns when subjected to axial force plus uniaxial bending. Have you done this? Respond in chat box. I'm waiting for the response. Yes. So now you look at this mu. What is the unit of mu? It is kilonewton meter. What is the unit of fck? So in the same set of units, I have to write, if I have to write fck, I will have to write it as kilonewton per meter square. If I were to write the b in same set of units, same set of system, it is meter, and this is meter square. So what is the unit of resulting quantity? This meter square will cancel with this meter square. It will be kilonewton meter by kilonewton meter. So this quantity is going to be unitless. Intentionally, we choose some unitless quantities or dimensionless parameters. You must have studied dimension analysis in fluid mechanics. There are some dimensionless numbers like Froude number. I'm sure that you have studied these numbers. So these dimensionless numbers do speak something about the physics of the problem. So wherever possible in the solution, we try to incorporate some dimension numbers which have physical significance. Do you agree with me? Type your response in chat box. Do you remember Froude number, Reynolds number that differentiates a laminar flow from turbulent flow? I hope you remember all those things. Do you remember that? Please type your response in chat box. Yes, so Vedang says yes. So on similar lines, in this solution also, we would like to introduce some dimensionless numbers or ratios. So what is the dimensionless number that we are going to introduce? So I am going to call the ratio of damping of the system to its critical damping as eta. This later on right hand side is pronounced as eta. This is unitless because it is essentially the ratio of same quantity. C is the damping coefficient of underdamped system, and C star is the damping coefficient of critically damped system. So if I take the ratio of C by C star, it is unitless quantity, and I denote it by number eta. Do you agree with me? this is dimensionless. Do you agree with me? Type your response in chat box, then I will proceed. Yes. So now let us go ahead. The moment I define eta in this fashion, it is but obvious that when eta is less than 1, that means C is less than C star, we are talking about underdamped system. When eta is equal to 1, that is C upon C star is 1, that means C is equal to C star, at that time we are talking about critically damped system. And when C is greater than C star, this eta will be greater than 1, at that time we are talking about the overdamped system. Do you agree with me? Respond in chat box. Please respond in chat box. Yes. Okay. So therefore, this dimensionless quantity or this ratio eta gives us the handover identifying the systems which are underdamped and which are critically damped and which are overdamped. Eta less than 1, underdamped system. Eta equal to 1, critically damped system. Eta greater than 1, overdamped system. Now, let us substitute the value of C star. So what is the value of C star? We have already seen C star is written as 2 square root of K into M, where K is the stiffness and M is the mass. Just remember this figure. K is the stiffness and M is the mass. Now, can I take M common? So if I take M common, that means I have to divide by M square under square root sign. So I will write 2m here, and if I divide km by m square, you will get k by m. So therefore, these two quantities are equal, 2m root k by m. But what is root k by m? Root k by m by definition is omega, which is the natural frequency of the system in radian per second. This we have studied earlier. Do you remember this? Please type your response in chat box. You remember that root k by m is omega, where omega is the natural frequency of the system when expressed in radian per second. So therefore 2m omega is also the alternative mathematical form of C star. So C star can either be 2 root km or it can also be 2m omega. You have to understand that. Now I am going to substitute the value of C star here and let us see what happens. So what is the value of B in this particular case? So I'm just borrowing this value of B here. It is root K by M minus C square upon 4M square. So K by M is omega square, because just now I said root K by M is omega. So if root K by M is omega, then only K by M is going to be omega square. So it is square root of omega square minus 1 by 4 C by M, the whole bracket square. But what is the value of C? C now can be written as C star into eta. So therefore I am going to replace this C by C star into eta, and then I am going to square it. So this second term becomes 1 by 4 eta square C star square upon m square. Obviously m square is sitting there. But what is the value of C star? Just now we derived C star is 2m omega. So if I substitute C star equal to 2m omega here, what I get is 4m square omega square eta square upon m square into 1 by 4. Now you will observe m square is going to get cancelled. 4, 4 is going to get cancelled. So what remains within is omega square minus eta omega square. Now can I take omega square common inside the root sign? Yes. So inside the root sign, if I take omega square common, what do I get? Square root of omega square into 1 minus eta. And omega square 1 minus eta, this omega square root of omega square is omega. I can take it out, and therefore I can write it as omega into square root of 1 minus eta square. Now this quantity, which is equal to b, I am going to call it as omega d, where omega d represents the damped natural frequency. This is called as damped natural frequency. Omega is natural frequency and omega d is damped natural frequency. Why do I call it as frequency? Because you will see in the solution we have cos bt, but that b is omega d. So when I say cos omega dt, omega d becomes the frequency of some sort, and therefore we are going to call it as a frequency, natural frequency, but damped one, when eta is not equal to zero. So now C by 2m, let us now rearrange this C by 2m term. So what is C by 2m? C is nothing but C star into eta. So I substitute that here, C star into eta upon 2m. But what is C star? 2m omega into eta upon 2m. 2m cancels out and you get C upon 2m as omega n, omega eta, sorry. So therefore, now what happens to this u of t? Just give me a second. Yeah, so what happens to this minus C by 2m? So it becomes e raised to minus eta omega t. T is sitting outside here. C by 2m is omega, C upon 2m is eta omega. So e raised to minus eta omega t sits outside. And inside, what is going to be there? It is going to be u0 cos bt. But what is b? B is nothing but omega into square root of 1 minus eta square, which is omega d. That's the new term that we have introduced. So therefore, it is going to be u0 cos omega dt plus u0 dot as it is. What is C by 2m? C by 2m is eta omega. So I am going to replace this C by 2m by eta omega. And this is nothing but b is omega d. So I am going to replace denominator by omega d. So what do I get? U0 dot plus omega eta u0 upon omega d into sine omega t. Are you with me till this point? Tell me, this is how the solution looks like. Please respond in chat box if you have understood this. Great. So now have a look at this. U of t is given by e raised to minus eta omega t, where omega is root k by m, which is the natural frequency, into u0 cos omega dt, where omega d is damped natural frequency, and it is given by omega into square root of 1 minus eta square, plus u0 dot plus omega eta u0 upon omega d into sine omega dt. Now tell me, in these two functions, which of the function is periodic in nature and which of the functions is decaying in nature? Chalo batao. E raised to minus eta omega t and whatever is there inside the bracket, in dono mein se periodic function kaun sa hai or decaying function kaun sa hai, time decaying function kaun sa hai? You can answer that in chat box. Okay, let us take a call. E raised to minus eta omega t, is it decaying function or is it periodic function? Type your response in chat box. E raised to eta omega t, decaying or periodic? Decaying function. Great. Very good. So e raised to minus eta omega t approaches systematically to zero as time t goes on increasing. At time t equal to infinity, this function would have reached the value zero, because then it will become e raised to minus infinity. Now, what about the bracket? Is it a decaying function or is it a periodic function? Again, answer in chat box. In bracket, do we have a decaying function or periodic function? Periodic function. So the product of periodic function into decaying function is ultimately going to be an oscillating function with reducing amplitude. Do you agree with me? What I mean to say is, zara yahan pe dekho, this e raised to eta omega t at time t equal to 0, what is its value? 1. So this function multiplied by whatever is there inside the bracket. So this is going to be the envelope on positive as well as negative side, because inside the bracket the function can assume positive as well as negative values. So this is e raised to minus eta omega t, this function on positive and negative side, when multiplied by the function in bracket which is periodic in nature, you are going to get the response of this sort. Do you agree with me? So this is the response. The response that I have marked in red color is the final response, final u of t. Are you able to understand this? This is bounded by e raised to minus eta omega t. That is the decaying function. Are you with me? Please type your response in chat box. Okay. Great. So you have understood the two parts of this solution. Omega d is omega into square root of 1 minus eta square. As I said, when eta is less than 1 under damped system, eta equal to 1. Now, a very particular thing happens when eta is equal to 1. Can you tell me what is going to happen to the term inside the bracket when eta is equal to 1? So let us substitute the value of eta equal to 1 here. So when I substitute eta equal to 1, what happens to omega d? Tell me. It is omega into square root of 1 minus 1 square. So for eta equal to 1, what is the value of omega d? Can you tell me? Respond in chat box. What happens to omega d? I'm waiting for your response in chat box. Are you able to hear me, Vedal? Yes. So omega d becomes 0. Very good. So if I substitute omega d's value as 0 here, just substitute omega d equal to 0 here. So what is going to happen? So you are going to have u0 here, and this second term is going to vanish. Do you agree with me? Because sin omega dt is 0. So you are going to have u of t as e raised to minus eta omega t u0. That's all. So this is only a decaying function, no periodic function. So when eta is equal to 1, the response is going to be always decaying. It will never cross 0. It is not the oscillating response. Do you agree with me? Ek hi cheez hai, lekin alag alag angle se hum wahi cheez prove kar rahe. Are you with me? Vedang, can you respond? Have you understood this? You can unmute and say so.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So that's what we are. It is slightly difficult to prove the same thing for eta greater than 1. But it's enough for us to do it for eta equal to 1. That is critically damped system. So now with all these exercises that we have done, now let us try to understand how do we define a overdamped system, a critically damped system, and an underdamped system. So what is critically damped system? Critically damped system has the lowest possible value of C for which the oscillations would not occur. Matlab, ab zara dhyan do, main kya kehne ki koshish kar raha hu. I am pulling this mass towards right. I am pulling this mass towards right, and I am leaving it. So I am pulling it towards right by amount u0. So I am going to mark u0 here. So now let us say this overdamped system starts. Let us start with the overdamped system. So for overdamped system, how is going to be the variation of u of t as a function of time? At time t equal to 0, you have pulled the mass towards right by amount u0. So it will start from here. For a overdamped system, this will systematically approach zero asymptotically. It will never cross the mean position. This is how the graph of u of t looks like for overdamped system. Do you agree with me? Vedang, you can unmute and tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now let us look at critically damped system. What happens for critically damped system? In critically damped system, we are reducing the value of C. Do you agree with me? Let us say for overdamped system, for the example that we have considered, let us say the value, we start from C equal to 600. We already know in that example C star is equal to 300. 200 tha? What was the value of C star? It was 2 root K into M, right?
It was 300, I guess.
No, 200. K tha 1000 or M tha 10. So 1000 into 10, square root of that is 100. 100 into 2 is 200. So C star was 200, if you remember, in our example. Do you agree with me, Vedang?
Yes, sir.
Now, when C is equal to 600, we know that the system is overdamped system, and therefore it is going to have this kind of response. Now, when C star is equal to 250, what is going to happen? Tell me. C star is equal to 250. I will show it with this line. As the C has reduced, the system will take longer time to have diminishing amplitude. Do you agree with me?
This
is C is equal to 200. It is still overdamped system. Do you agree with me? 250. I'm sorry. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the lowest value of C to which I can take C such that I do not change the nature of the response? 200. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So what happens at C equal to 200? The system will start something like this, and it will take the longest time to have diminishing magnitude amplitude of U of T. Do you agree with me? This is C star equal to 200, and it is still overdamped system. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what if I bring C below this? Ab kya hone wala hai? Bata. If I bring the C below this, now what you are going to see is this. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So this is where C is less than 200. Happy?
Yes.
जितना ज्यादा लेस होगा उतना ज्यादा टाइम लगेगा सिस्टम को रेस्ट में आने के लिए, एम्पलीट्यूड डिक्रीज होते जाने के लिए. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
हां, तो अब जरा मुझे बताओ, हाउ डू आई डिफाइन ए क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड सिस्टम? क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड सिस्टम और फॉर दैट मैटर हाउ डू आई डिफाइन क्रिटिकल डैम्पिंग सी स्टार? क्रिटिकल डैम्पिंग सी स्टार इज दैट वैल्यू इज द लोएस्ट वैल्यू ऑफ डैम्पिंग for which the system does not exhibit oscillations about the mean position when disturbed from the mean position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
देखो, C को हम कम करते गए, कम 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 करते गए, कहां तक कम कर सकते हैं? Such that there are no oscillations about the mean position. तो C star तक कर सकते हैं. C star से जैसे ही तुम नीचे जाओगे, you will at least have one oscillation about the mean position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So now we have physics in hand. How do we define critically damped system? Abhi tak to humne kaise define kiya tha? We said that when C is greater than C star, it is overdamped. When C is equal to C star, it is underdamped. It is critically damped. Are you with me? And when C is less than C star, it is underdamped. या दूसरा एक वे था हमारा सिस्टम को डिफाइन करने का. क्या वे था? व्हेन जो हमारा एस के रूट रहते थे वो स्क्वायर रूट के साइन के अंदर, इफ द टर्म बिकम्स ग्रेटर देन वन, इफ द स्क्वायर रूट के अंदर का जो टर्म है, इफ दैट इज ग्रेटर देन वन, इट इज ओवरडैम्प्ड सिस्टम. इफ इट इज इक्वल टू ग्रेटर देन जीरो, देन इट इज ओवरडैम्प्ड सिस्टम. इफ इट इज इक्वल टू जीरो, क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड. एंड इफ इट इज लेस देन जीरो, देन इट इज अंडरडैम्प्ड सिस्टम. ऐसे किया था कि नहीं?
यस.
But that was mathematical definition of overdamped, underdamped, and critically damped systems. What is the definition, physical definition of critically damped system? How do you know whether the system is critically damped, overdamped, or underdamped? You just disturb the system from mean position. If it exhibits oscillations, it is definitely underdamped system. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
If it does not exhibit oscillations, it can either be critically damped or it can be overdamped. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is critical damping? Critical damping is that value, that lowest value of damping for which the oscillations do not prevail when the system is disturbed from its mean position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
That is the physical definition of underdamped, overdamped, and critically damped systems. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So we have covered a lot of ground. We have seen the definition of underdamped system, overdamped system, and critically damped system through many angles. We have also reached at the solution for free vibration of such systems. Do you agree with me? Now we are going to deal with something called as forced vibration. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So let me write it. So we are now going to deal with forced vibrations. Before we do that, I am going to define something called as single degree of freedom system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Single degree of freedom system. We denote it by SDOF. This is the standard short form of single degree of freedom system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
The moment you are going to define something called a single degree of freedom system, you must know or you must imagine that there will be a multiple degree of freedom system. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
That is by standard short form, it is called as MDOF. So we are going to deal with SDOF and MDOF systems in this course. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Chal, what is your gut feeling? Ye jo system humne consider kiya, is it a single degree of freedom system or multi degree of freedom system? Batao, Vedan. What is it? Yes, Vedan.
Yes, sir, I'm thinking.
Anyone else? You can unmute and you can tell me whether, what do you think, whether it is a single degree of freedom system or multi degree of freedom system? You can also type your answer in chat box. It's okay. So Vaibhav says it is single degree of freedom system. Yes, you are absolutely right, Vaibhav. It is single degree of freedom system for sure. Shreyas also says that it is single degree of freedom system. That's correct. So now, if we know that it is single degree of freedom system, Vedant, can you define what is degree of freedom for me? Can you define for me what is degree of freedom?
Sir, the number of available motions.
Excellent. So if you have a mass, mass hona zaruri hai. Kiska motion dekhna hai? Hame mass ka motion dekhna hai. In dynamics, we have to look at the motion of a mass. So if this mass, the number of displacements or rotations possible by definition are called as degrees of freedom. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So degree, typically, generally, how many degrees of freedom can a mass have? Maximum. Kitne ho sakte hai? 6. Very good. Konse? So you have translation in x direction, then you have translation in y direction, you can have translation in z direction, rotation of mass about x axis, about y axis, and about z axis. So 3 translational degrees of freedom and 3 rotational degrees of freedom are possible. Are you with me, Vedan?
Yes, sir.
Yes. But in this particular case, we are allowing the mass to move only in one direction, or we are bothered about its motion only in one direction. We are not bothered about what happens to other directions. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So whenever we are dealing with only one displacement of a given mass, and there is only one mass in the system, two conditions hai. Kon se? Ek hi mass hai. Aur dusra kya hai? Us mass ke bhi ek hi displacement hum dekh rahe. उस टाइम हम उस सिस्टम को बोलते हैं सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
देयर कैन बी मल्टीपल मासेस एंड यू मे बी ऑब्जर्विंग देयर मोशन ओनली इन वन डायरेक्शन, बट देन इट बिकम्स मल्टी डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम बिकॉज फॉर एवरी मास यू विल हैव टू कीप ट्रैक ऑफ इट्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
सो एम आई वेरी क्लियर व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम?
Yes, sir.
एक ही मास होना चाहिए सिस्टम में और उसका एक ही डिस्प्लेसमेंट हम देख. वी आर इंटरेस्टेड ओनली इन वन ऑफ इट्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
ऐसे सिस्टम को हम बोलेंगे सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम. देन डू सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम्स एग्जिस्ट? प्रैक्टिकली द आंसर इज यस. आज ही हमने लैब एक्सरसाइज में एक प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करना शुरू किया है. डू यू रिमेम्बर दैट, वैभव? वेदांत?
Yes, sir. We are solving. Yes.
Yes. So that problem is the demonstration of the example of a system which can be idealized as a single degree of freedom system. और वो कोई ख्याली पुलाव नहीं है. Those examples do prevail in the site, on the site. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, there are some systems which are available which can be modeled as single degree of freedom systems themselves. But right, that's sir. Not the only the utility of analyzing single degree of freedom system. जो multi degree of freedom systems है, उनको भी n number of single degree of freedom system जैसा analyze किया जा सकता है. Are you with me? So let us say if it is a 10 degree of freedom system, it is as good as, I can convert the problem in such a fashion that it is as good as I am solving 10 single degree of freedom systems. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So ye focus rakhna. So single degree of, there are some structural system out in the outside world which are amenable for their representation as single degree of freedom system. There are other systems which have multi degree of freedom representation, but with some mathematical operation on them, we can convert them into the assembly of single degree of freedom systems. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then अभी ये जो हमने analysis किया, वो ऐसे के ऐसे वहाँ पे extend किया जा सकता है. Are you with me?
Right, sir.
So ये single degree of freedom system बाहर कहाँ दिखते हैं? एकदम फुद्दू analysis से ऐसे मत बोलना. It has its implications. सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम एक बार आप सीख गए उसको कैसे एनालाइज करना है, वी कैन एक्सटेंड दैट एनालिसिस टू एनालाइज ए मल्टी डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम एज वेल. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
ओके, सो विद दिस बैकग्राउंड नाउ वी आर टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड डैम्प्ड एंड अनडैम्प्ड सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम फॉर इट्स फ्री वाइब्रेशन. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
फ्री वाइब्रेशन मतलब एक बार उसको खींचा, डिस्टर्ब किया and you leave it. There is no other external force acting on the system for rest of its motion. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
That is called as free vibration. Damped, matlab kya? The damping is not at all present. Sorry, undamped matlab damping is not at all present. The system will keep on vibrating forever. And what is damped system? Damped systems may have three types. One is underdamped, another is overdamped, and third one is critically damped. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
तो ये सारे सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम्स के हमने फ्री वाइब्रेशन के एनालिसिस कर लिए. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ पोस्ट वाइब्रेशन. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
सो हाउ डू आई रिप्रेजेंट ए फोर्स ऑन दिस सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम, वो जरा मुझे बताओ. सो फ्रॉम दिस क्लास ऑनवर्ड्स आई एम गोइंग टू कॉल दिस सिस्टम एज ए सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
हाँ, तो एक चीज आपको मैं बताना चाहता हूँ. सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम में तीन एलिमेंट्स हमने दिखाए हैं. कौन कौन से एलिमेंट्स दिखाए? एक है मास एलिमेंट. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
डज मास एलिमेंट हैव एनी स्टिफनेस? नो, मास एलिमेंट को कोई स्टिफनेस नहीं है. दूसरा एलिमेंट सेपरेटली हमने ऐड किया है, उसको बोला जाता है स्टिफनेस एलिमेंट. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
डज दिस स्प्रिंग हैव एनी मास? नहीं. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
और तीसरा एलिमेंट है जो बोला जाता है डैम्पर एलिमेंट. डज दिस डैम्पर हैव एनी मास और एनी स्टिफनेस? नो. सो देयरफॉर द मास एलिमेंट इन दिस रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम डज नॉट हैव एनी स्टिफनेस और एनी डैम्पिंग. द स्टिफनेस एलिमेंट दैट स्प्रिंग डजंट हैव एनी मास और डैम्पिंग. एंड दिस डैम्पिंग एलिमेंट सी डैशपॉट डैम्पिंग, इसको बोलते हैं डैशपॉट मॉडल. It doesn't have any stiffness or it doesn't have any mass. Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In reality, जो हमने आज दोपहर को problem consider किया था वो कुछ ऐसा था. Do you remember that? You had a slab here. समझ में आ रहा है?
Yes.
So even the columns that provide the stiffness to this mass, they also had mass. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Damping will be derived through from throughout the structure. So in reality, we do not have mass, stiffness and damping as distinct elements. Aise nahi hote. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But this is just a mathematical representation of the real life single degree of freedom system that you have to understand. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, having said that, now what will make the vibrations as force vibrations. Zara batao mujhe kya kisko main forced vibration bolu. Chalo bolo.
So can we purposely apply a force on the mass?
Correct. So I'm going to show a force, something called as F of T. Do you agree with me?
Sure.
Here. And that force has to be function of time. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Then only it can cause vibrations. Ab zara yaad karo, even before we started our class, I had asked you a question. Which of the following loads will you consider as dynamic loads and which are not? Do you remember that question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now tell me, what is the criteria? Ye jab main F of T likhta hu, to ye kaun se tarike ka load hai ki jisko main dynamic load consider kar sakta hu? और कौन से ऐसे लोड है कि जिनको स्टैटिक लोड ही कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा? बोलो
सर. अ चेंजिंग लोड वी विल
कंसीडर. यू आर सिटिंग एट अ लोकेशन ऑन अ चेयर, यू आर सिटिंग ऑन अ चेयर एट अ पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन फॉर 6 आवर्स. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड देन यू लीव द चेयर एंड यू डोंट सिट देयर फॉर नेक्स्ट 8 आवर्स. समझ में आ रहा है? तो ये लोड का ग्राफ कैसे होगा जरा बताओ मुझे. स्लैब पे ये ग्राफ कैसे रहने वाला है? हाउ इज द ग्राफ, टेल मी. सो इफ आई प्लॉट
फॉर द फर्स्ट फ्यू आवर्स
टाइम इन सेकंड्स ऑन एक्स एक्सिस, तो पहले 6 आवर्स मतलब कितने सेकंड्स बताओ? 3600
into 6
21600. हां, और यहां पे 3600 into 14 मतलब टोटल कितने आवर्स हुए? 14 आवर्स हुए. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
योर वेट इज हाउ मच, टेल मी?
70 फॉर एग्जांपल.
हां ओके, 70 into 9.81. डू यू एग्री विद मी? तो ये ग्राफ कैसे रहेगा? आप 6 घंटे कुर्सी पे बैठे रहे तो स्लैब के ऊपर लोड आता रहा, उसके बाद एट वन फाइन मोमेंट यू जस्ट लेफ्ट.
Yes.
And then the load was zero. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Can you consider this as dynamic load or should you consider it as static load?
The static load.
And why? What is the criteria?
Because in that particular duration of first 6 hours, the load was constant, and then in the next 8 hours, the load was constant.
Oh, okay. Now let us say you sit there for 30 seconds and you leave the room. For next 30 seconds, again after the 30 seconds, you sit here for 30 seconds. Still in that 30 seconds, the load was not changing. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Ab usko dynamic bologe ya static bologe? Do you understand my question?
Yes, sir.
Kaun se load ko dynamic bola jaye aur kaun se load ko dynamic na bola jaye? This question almost goes towards philosophy. We are going to answer it objectively and quantitatively, qualitatively as well, but little later. Maine question to raise kar diya. There is a food for thought. Aap socho ki kaun se load ko dynamic bola jayega aur kaun se ko static bola jayega. Are you with me? But before we do that, let me try and understand what are the various types of forces that can act on this mass m. What is the variation? Kaise variation time ke hisab se ho sakta hai? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So let me try to figure this out. I am going to draw few diagrams here and you are going to tell me what do you call that load as. Apne apne aaj tak jo sikha hai usko uske hisab se mujhe batao. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
चलो बोलो, व्हाट डू यू कॉल दिस लोड एज?
इट्स अ वेरिंग लोड.
दैट्स ऑब्वियस, एवरी लोड इज वेरिंग, दैट्स फाइन. बट व्हाट डू यू कॉल दिस लोड एज? डू यू कॉल इट एज इंपल्स? वेदांग,
Yes, sir.
What
I
is the
guess.
definition
Yes,
of
sir.
impulse? A large amount of force is transferred between the two objects for a very short duration of time. Delta t is tending to zero here. Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So can I call this as impulsive force?
Yes, sir.
Happy?
Sir.
So impulsive force prevails for a moment and then it vanishes. Do you agree
yes,
with
sir.
Me? Chalo, force to vanish hua, lekin the system will keep on oscillating. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And those oscillations will be very similar to free vibration, but they are under the forced vibe. They are under the impulsive force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Acha. So, ab zara mujhe batao, if this f of t is this kind of a force, that means ye kaise, practically kaise isko achieve kiya ja sakta hai? You take a hammer, hit the mass, and that's all. Let it vibrate on account of this hitting. समझ में आ रहा है क्या? इसको हम इंपल्सिव फोर्स बोल सकेंगे? Do you agree with me, Vedang?
Yes, sir.
अच्छा, so have you studied any of the techniques which are called as rebound hammer test? ये कभी सुना
yes,
है?
Sir.
हाँ, तो
yes,
उसमें
sir.
क्या करते हैं? You just hit a particular part of a structure with the hammer. And then, depending upon the rebound, you take measurements, what all and what not. But is that a impulsive force? Yes, it is impulsive force. So, a kind of force ho sakta hai, kaun sa impulsive force? Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Acha, aur kaun se tarike ka force ho sakta hai? Zara batao. So, ab zara yaha pe dhyan do. Ye hai dusre tarike ka force. T इक्वल टू इंफिनिटी तक ये फोर्स F ही रहेगा. इस फोर्स को आप क्या बोलते हो, जरा बताओ? What do you call this force as? Yes, Vedant, go ahead.
सिर्फ constantly applied force of the same magnitude.
No, no, is it constantly applied? No, it was not there till T1. And then from
direction.
T1 to T equal to infinity, it was always there. समझ में आ रहा है? ऐसे फोर्स को क्या बोलोगे आप? बताओ. देखो अब मैं क्या एक I am going to do an exercise. This is a table top. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
I am holding a book with my hands. Then I bring down my hand till the time book is just touching the table. Still I am holding the book. None
yes.
of the force from book's weight is transferred to the tabletop. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then I just leave my hands. The entire force now is transferred to the tabletop in a moment. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But that force continues to remain there for a long time. It's not like an impulsive force, which where the force also diminishes within a short interval of time. It is like a spike. You apply a force and then it is removed. Aise nahi hai. I
yes,
applied
sir.
A force in an instant and then it was there forever. Are you with me?
Yes, yes, sir.
To aise force ko kya bolte hai? Bolo. We call this as sudden force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Sudden force or instantaneous? No, not instantaneous. That also will be a wrong word. It is sudden force, but it is going to stay there after once it is applied. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
अच्छा और एक force बता दो. Just have a look at this force. What is this? Suddenly applied and suddenly removed force. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
It was applied suddenly and it was removed as well suddenly. As against this, what is a gradual force? So, जरा देखो आपने book का जो top है वो table top से touch किया, then slowly you are releasing your load on your hands. So therefore, slowly the load is getting transferred to the tabletop, and ultimately you just leave your hands. That is gradual application of force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
ऐसे तो नहीं है, ये force is sudden है. So it is suddenly applied force and suddenly removed force. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Applied and removed. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
अब तीसरे तरीके का फोर्स देखो. What will you call this force as? बोलो. If I denote
oscillating, this, oscillating.
Yes. So if I denote this as F is equal to 10 sin lambda t. So would you call it as sinusoidal force?
Yes, sir. It will be a periodic function.
It will be periodic function. That's right. So this is, but not only periodic. It is also a sinusoidal force. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, अब जरा यहाँ पे ध्यान दो, ये कौन से तरीके का फोर्स है? दिस इज ऑल्सो पीरियोडिक. डू यू एग्री विथ
मी? यस सर.
इट इज नॉट साइनसोइडल. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
सो आई विल जस्ट मेंशन इट एज अ पीरियोडिक फोर्स. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
अब जरा यहाँ पे देखो, ये फोर्स कौन से तरीके का है? Force as a function of time. बोलो, क्या बोलोगे इसको? General force. Are you
there? Yes, sir.
General force. चलो, तो इतने सारे forces हो सकते हैं, इसके ऊपर हम apply कर सकते हैं. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
अब सबसे ज्यादा important हमारे लिए कौन से forces है? What are the forces that we need to solve this system or analyze this system for? Definitely one is impulsive force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And the second one is sinusoidal force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Natural question you will ask is why? Because all the other variations of force, you know that any other function can be represented by Fourier series. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And Fourier series involves which kind of functions? Sinusoidal and cosine functions. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So therefore, there is no doubt that if I have a response of a system for sinusoidal force by applying Fourier series, I will be able to decompose all other forces in terms of addition of various sine functions, and then I can write down the response of a system. That is for sure. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, next question you will ask is, why should I analyze for impulsive force? इसके लिए मैं क्यों analyze करूँ? तो अब जरा उसका मैं आपको static equivalent बताने वाला हूँ, and possibly after that we will define one more term and then we will stop for today. मैं जरा static equivalent आपको बताता हूँ. चलो.
Yes, sir.
If this is a fixed, so this is digress. This is digress. Now,
yes, sir.
Tell me, if you have a point load here, P, is point load possible in reality? नहीं, क्योंकि
no.
Point का length कितना है? Zero. Width कितना है? Zero. और thickness कितना है? Zero. How can something that is force will be transferred through nothing? Are you with me?
Right, sir. Yes, sir.
So therefore, point load is an idealization. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes. But it is very good idealization. Why? Because let us say this is A and this is B. Can you tell me what is the fixed state moment here? Iska formula batao zara. You cannot afford to forget this. Yeah, tell me.
P into B by L.
P A B square upon L square, where L is equal to A plus B. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the formula here? Tell me. P B A
square
upon L square.
Square.
Agreed? अब जरा समझो, I ask you to find out ये UDL है, तो UDL के वजह से, UDL का इंटेंसिटी है W, उसके वजह से यहाँ पे कितने फिक्स्ड एंड मोमेंट्स होंगे ये फाइंड आउट करो, ऐसे मैंने आपको बोला. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
सो हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू डू इट? सो आई विल शो यू हाउ टू डू इट क्विकली. आई विल कंसिडर एट डिस्टेंस x ए स्मॉल स्ट्रिप ऑफ विड्थ dx. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
dx इज सो स्मॉल सच दैट whatever is the load over dx, I can idealize it as a point load. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So if this is x, I can safely say, neglecting dx, that this is L minus x. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So dx is tending to 0. So then I can call this portion as L minus x and this portion as x. Now, can you tell me how much is the load acting over this dx? dx ke upar load kitna act ho raha hai? Isn't it w into dx?
Yes, sir.
Can I say it is a point load? Yes. So what is the fixed end moment at this end A due to this WDX? It is WDX into X into L minus X bracket square, WAB square upon L square. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And how many such strips are there from X equal to 0 to X equal to L? So if I integrate this from X equal to 0 to X equal to L, I am going to get fixed end moment at end A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Due to UDL. Similarly, let there be a complicated type of load. It's all right. As long as I am able to denote the intensity as a function of x, I will just substitute that value of w as a function of x here. I will integrate this and I will get the value of fixed end moment at A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So point load consider karne ke fayde kya hai? Ek fayda to ye hai कि एनालिसिस में पॉइंट लोड के वजह से आने वाले क्वांटिटीज तो मुझे मिल जाते हैं. दूसरा ये है कि जो जनरलाइज लोड है उसको भी मैं ट्रेन ऑफ पॉइंट लोड जैसे अज्यूम कर सकता हूं. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड देन आई कैन एस्टीमेट द रिक्वायर्ड क्वांटिटीज बाय इंटीग्रेशन. अब जो हमने ये स्पेस में किया वही हम इधर टाइम में करेंगे. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट अस से the real load is this in time. Can I consider it as impulses of small durations one after the other? Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So jo humne point load ke hisab se kiya wahi yahan pe karenge. I will consider the complex generalized load in time as impulses received by the system one after the other. Are you with me?
Right, sir.
And I can analyze the response of the system to that generalized load. So, jo point load ka kaam hai statics mein, wohi impulsive force ka kaam hai dynamics mein. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ab aaj ke class ka ek last concept hum define karenge. And then we are going to go ahead with the analysis of this single degree of freedom system to this forced vibrations. Are you with me? And now,
yes, sir.
I am going to define something called as Dirac delta function. Have you heard of this?
No, sir.
Okay. So let me define what is Dirac delta function. Chalo. Just give me a second. Imagine that I have a force F which is acting over a time period T1 to T2. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the time over which it acts? It acts over a time T2 minus T1, which I am going to call it as
zero.
Delta T. Okay. Are you with me? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And F into delta T. This is what? This is the area under force time diagram. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
This is one. This is my requirement. I have set it in this fashion. F is such that F into delta T is one. Do you agree with me?
Yes,
can
sir.
I do that? Yes. I can
yes,
have a choice of F and I can have a choice of T1 and T2 such that F into delta T is one. Do you agree with
yes,
me?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Now, if I half the delta T ko maine agar half kiya, Are you with me? So यहाँ पे ही draw करना है पर visualization के लिए यहाँ पे draw करता हूँ. So this now is delta t by 2. Do you agree with me?
Yes sir.
तो to maintain this relationship मुझे f को क्या करना पड़ेगा? Double करना पड़ेगा. Do you agree with me?
Yes sir.
So ये f 2f हो जाएगा. So that 2f into delta t by 2 will still be 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes sir.
अच्छा ये डेल्टा टी को अगर मैंने डेल्टा टी बाय 4 किया तो 2f को क्या करना पड़ेगा? 4f करना 4F. पड़ेगा. ये डेल्टा टी को अगर मैंने 0 किया एंड आई पुट ए वियर्ड कंडीशन दैट आई वांट द एरिया अंडर द f इनटू डेल्टा टी कर्व टू बी 1 तो मुझे f को क्या करना पड़ेगा?
सर ऑलमोस्ट 1.
नो इनफाइनाइट. देखो डेल्टा टी by n जब मैं करता हूँ तो मुझे n times f करना पड़ता है so that the area under the curve remains 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Now in the limit as delta t tends to 0 that means n tends to infinity है ना?
Yes.
So delta t upon infinity तो मुझे f को क्या करना पड़ेगा? Infinite करना पड़ेगा. Are you with me?
Yes.
हाँ but what I am actually trying to do is I am taking a limit as delta t tends to 0 but area under the FT diagram is tending to 1. Happy?
Yes.
ये limit अगर मैंने इसके ऊपर ले लिया तो जो मुझे मिलता है function उसको मैं बोलूंगा direct delta function. Are you with me?
Yes sir.
So what is direct delta function? Direct delta function occurs at an instant of time because delta t is tending to 0 but it assumes that value which is infinity per se but it is such that the area under direct delta function is 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes sir.
Iska matlab hai if I take the integration of direct delta function integration is nothing but the area under the curve. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
From time minus infinity to plus infinity, that function prevails only at the value of only at a particular instant, but its integration is going to be 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
This is what we call as a direct delta function. What are its consequences? How do we differentiate direct delta function? How do we integrate direct delta function? What is the more formal and mathematical definition of direct delta function coming up in next class?
Yes, sir.
And how is it related to whatever we were doing also coming up in next class? So with this, let us stop here today. If you have any doubts, you can unmute yourself and ask. Otherwise, we are going to stop here. Now, I am going to mark the attendance here itself. So don't go away.